Well, every year, thousands of children are hurt or killed because a driver backing up their vehicle didn't see them. And most of these tragic accidents happen in residential driveways or in parking lots. 6 News anchor Lori Tucker joins us now here in the studio with much more. Lori?
Yeah, Kristen, you know, in 70% of these backover cases, it's a parent or another relative behind the wheel. It is so tragic and needless. And joining us now with more is Susan Cook, who is injury prevention coordinator at Children's Hospital. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
You know, how big is this problem?
It's really very, very big. There's actually 50 children every week involved in a backover incident. And out of that 50, two are going to be fatalities.
Oh, my goodness. That is so many more than people realize. I am so sure. Now, let's take a look right now at a picture. This says the story. Mm-hmm. It's from kidsincars.org. It demonstrates how hard it can be to spot a child when you're backing out of the driveway. And that is about 30 children behind that SUV. In the blind spot, the driver would not be able to see a single one of those children.
An average SUV has a blind spot in the back up to about 50 feet, about 8 feet forward. So it's a very, very large blind zone.
What do we do to prevent this?
There are several different things you can do. The first thing you want to really make sure is that you're do a walkabout. It's a 5-second, just walk around that vehicle, make sure that there's no children back there playing. You also, when it comes to playing with the children there in the driveway, make sure that they realize that that's not a play area. So you're checking that car. And then once again, you're really going to limit any kind of play around the driveway even. And then set a safe zone to where kids know, you know, even if the vehicle's parked, this is not a play area.
Yeah, and even if you get one of the newer cars that does have the honking sounds and the camera, it's still good to do that check, isn't it?
It's still very good to do that because you don't really want to rely completely on that camera because, once again, if a child runs by, that camera's great for, you know, steal items. Mm-hmm. However, if you have a kid that's running after a ball or a pet, once again, by the time that they get behind that, it may be a little bit too late, depending on the speed you're going. Mm.
All right. Really, really good information. Thank you so much, Susan, for being with us. And if you have a question about your child's health, just email me. My address is ltucker@wate.com. And of course, be sure to tune in every Thursday here on 6 News at 5:30. You never know. We may just use your question on the air. Kristen?